The 615th Contingency Response Wing ceased its operations as a CRW, ending 7 years of mobility excellence. The inactivation ceremony served as an opportunity to reflect at some of the CRW's accomplishments.
Whether it's supporting relief efforts in Darfur, Haiti, Japan, or the hurricane-ravaged southern United States coast, or opening airfields in western Afghanistan to support the president's surge strategy for Operation Enduring Freedom, or opening an airbase in Kuwait in support of Operations New Dawn's retrograde from Iraq. Men and women of the 615th have performed with consistent excellence.
Part of the ceremony included the transfer of command of two contingency response groups and one contingency operations support group to the 621st Contingency Response Wing, headquartered at Joint Base McGuire-Dix Lakehurst in New Jersey.
I have no doubt that the airmen will remain versatile, mobile, and disciplined to accomplish their mission. In fact, for most of the airmen, the job is unchanged. The task they did yesterday are the same task they will do tomorrow. But with any change comes opportunity, the opportunity to embrace differences and learn from each other and become more efficient and more effective.
While the 615th legacy may have come to an end, the 621st remains as the Air Force's only contingency response wing and remains postured to perform in locations around the globe as America's 911 mobility response force. Staff Sergeant John Ayre, Travis Air Force Base, California.
Good morning, everyone. What a great show, and I'm really glad we have this indoors today. Interesting Northern California weather here in the summer. Thank you all so much for coming today. I'll start by thanking General Bender for coming out and officiating the ceremony, so thanks very much. And I'd also like to thank some very special guests for being here today, and that's our elected officials and community leaders. We enjoy the best community support that I've seen in my career here at Travis, so I'd like to quickly recognize a few of them for being here. Starting off, Supervisor Raymond, the gentleman for being here, Mayor Price, Mayor Sanchez, thank you very much for coming. Representing Assemblywoman Yamada Dalmanara, thank you for being here. District Representative Zara Dressler, thank you for coming. I'd also like to thank Councilmember Fuller, thank you for coming. And all the way in from Reno, this is to my incredible teammates, the Queen Commanders, to Dwight Dana, who's coming out today, and First Colonel Fulmer, thanks for being here. To all the commanders, chiefs, first sergeants, and all the men and women of the Travis team, thanks for coming out to this event with us today, and especially to the family members and friends that are here. Today we mark the end of an era of proven excellence as we inactivate the 615th Star Regiment. But before we proceed, I thought it'd be appropriate to think about how the CRWs got to where they are today. The United States and our senior mobility leaders realized that if you want to influence the outcome of dynamic situations in the world, whether it be a contingency, a humanitarian crisis, or a natural disaster, you've got to be able to respond quickly, getting there in hours, not days. And you've got to be able to set up airfield operations, run air operations, and sustain them. And that's exactly what we do in this CRW. For these reasons, the United States committed to this incredible capability and is now resident in two CRWs. We started off with the predecessors of the Tinker Airlift Control Element of Towson. It then evolved to the Air Mobility Operations Groups, and finally evolved into what we know today as contingency response. With each evolution, critical skill sets were added to the organization, rounding out the overall capabilities that our nation was looking for. Today, our contingency response forces are razor sharp, ready to answer our nation's call, and deploy at a moment's notice anywhere in the world to set up and sustain air operations. The capabilities of the CRWs now far exceed what was initially envisioned, and we've seen in the past years that combatant commands continually calling on us for support. I couldn't be more proud of our CR warriors. Their service, sacrifice, and dedication is nothing short of amazing, and the pride, passion, and professionalism with which they do their jobs is incredible. Whether it's supporting relief efforts in Darfur, Haiti, Japan, or the hurricane-ravaged southern United States coast, or opening airfields in western Afghanistan, to support the President's surge strategy for Operation Enduring Freedom. We're opening an airbase in Kuwait in support of Operations New Dawn's retrograde from Iraq. The men and women of the 615th have performed with consistent excellence, always making us proud, always giving us humility. It's been the absolute highest honor of my career to command this special mission wing with very special people throughout. With a team of air mobility liaison officers, contingency response forces, air mobility division, command and control experts, and most recently, building partner capacity warriors who've gone from 0 to 60 in such a short time and are already having strategic impact with their partner nations. What a team we've assembled here. So we are prepared to combine the two contingency response wings into a single consolidated wing today. And I can assure all of you that the West Coast CRW warriors are prepared to answer our nation's call, wherever and whenever they are needed. I can also assure you that these men and women are ready to integrate into the 621st and help take the wing to new heights. With change comes great opportunity. We have an opportunity to take the best practices of the two existing wings and combine them into a single wing to make it even better. It takes great leaders to effectively manage change like we're going through. but we will undoubtedly be successful. As I look around this wing, we certainly have a lot of great leaders. John Quincy Adams said, if your actions inspire others to dream more, learn more, do more, and become more, you are a leader. By that definition, we surely have a lot of leaders here in this organization. I'm continually impressed by the people in the 615th who inspired others, and I feel completely confident that they will indeed help the wing reach new heights. As an outgoing commander, I have some very important thank yous to say, first and foremost for my family. Trish is here on the room of Lauren and Elise have finals today, so it couldn't be more. But thank you. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your support. Thank you for always giving up for me. I couldn't have done this without you. Okay. I'm good. All right. I also need to thank my great two right-hand men, my vice, Colonel John Payne, and my outstanding command chief Michael Flint. I couldn't have asked for two better professionals to work with. Your advice has always been spot on, and your dedication has been amazing. Thanks for everything, gentlemen. You made my command experience that much extra special. Thanks to my current honorary commander, Mr. Moran, who couldn't be here today. Publicly acknowledge his friendship and support. And I also want to thank our former honorary commander, the same person, our friendship with Sandy and Jack. Thanks to my amazing front office staff, Kathy, Troy, Eric, who's still there, and the entire command section. Thank you very much. You guys have been tremendous. And really appreciate all the hard work you've done. To our incredible group commanders, group chiefs, squadron commanders, first sergeants, and really leaders throughout, as I mentioned. My hat's off to you. You're phenomenal professionals. Thanks for your leadership, and thanks for all that you do. And finally, to all the men and women of the 615th CRW, thank you for your selfless service, sacrifice, dedication, and commitment to excellence. You may be excited about giving up and coming to work with me. As I close, I'd ask everyone here today to reflect on the words of a classical historian held in the war, who more than 2,000 years ago described perfectly the demands of service and work. When he said, the bravest are surely those who have a clear vision of what is before them. Glory and danger alike, and yet notwithstanding, go out and meet it. Crispy, I can assure you today that the forces on the West Coast that will be joining the 621st are ready to go out and meet it, whatever it may be. I wish you all the best, combined wing, and the CRW Warriors. Thank you all again for being here today. God bless you.
Ceremony is steeped in military tradition and symbolism. The 615th Contingency Operations Support Group, 570th Contingency Response Group, and 571st Contingency Response Group will be represented on stage by their commander, who will carry the colors of his unit. These colors are currently located to your right.